سلو. What's a his flow?
Combining multiple equations to get one equation.
Find the heat or the enthalpy of one equation, exactly. And I gave you this example. I want you to do it now yourself. Look at it here and do this example yourself quickly. I'm not going to do it. You should be able to do it yourself. What we want, yeah, we did this yesterday. Look at this one more time. We have three equations. I'll call it equation 1, 2, and 3. Out of these, I want to make this equation. What should you do?
We should just flip the equation number 2.
First equation, what should you do with the first equation?
First equation, leave it as it is.
Keep, exactly. So first equation, keep as is, exactly. All right, then third equation. Let's go to third equation because I'm interested in O here, and in O, there is O here. What should I do to make the third equation?
We should flip it.
Reverse.
And multiply by half.
Multiply by?
Divide half. By 2.
Half or divide by 2, exactly. Multiply by half or divide by 2, exactly. All right? And then the third equation.
The second equation, we should flip it.
Second?
Reverse.
Just simply reverse. Okay, do it yourself now and get the answer. Are you done?
-304.
Somebody is suggesting that delta H for the last reaction is -300. And four?
Yes.
No, the answer, but who got the same answer?
I got the same answer.
Okay. Any question before we go to the next slide? Did you try to do it, all of you? All right, good. Let's see.
Doctor.
All right, next. We have standard enthalpy of formation. What's the standard enthalpy of formation? Define what is standard enthalpy of formation. HF and standard stand for the circle, the standard, and formation is F, stands for F, and H is the enthalpy. Define what's the enthalpy of formation. H, F, O. What is it?
It's the
energy or the enthalpy
of the natural molecules or.
No. What's the enthalpy of making compound from what?
From natural resources, yeah. Or
from no, from naturally occurring constituent. Naturally occurring constituents. How much energy is to make a compound from naturally occurring constituent? And that's why, if you want to write it for any compound, let's say, for example, let's take any compound, C6H12O6, for example. What's the enthalpy of formation of this compound? What should you do?
6C.
What's the equation? Yes, you should say 6C solid or graphite.
Plus 6H2 gas.
Plus 6H2 gas, exactly.
Plus 3H2O, 3O, 2 gas.
Yes, not H2O. Okay, excellent. So this is the equation that represent the heat of formation of this to make this compound. I hope it's clear. I hope it is clear. Good. And I told you that heat of formation of naturally occurring constituent is considered to be equal to what?
Zero.
Zero for naturally occurring constituent. What do I mean by naturally occurring constituent? How the element exists in the nature. For example, if we have sodium, it should be sodium what?
Solid.
Solid. How about Na plus? Is this zero?
No.
This is not natural occurring constituent.
No, it's not zero. Na plus, I mean Na solid is zero. Give me an example of natural occurring constituent other than sodium.
O2.
O2, and then you have to say the state.
Gas.
Yes, you must say this, O2 gas, because if I have, for example, N2 liquid, which is N2 gas, the gas N2 nitrogen liquid, is this delta H, is it zero?
No.
No, what is zero? N2 gas, all right? And don't forget, what are the gases? Let's put all the gases. First, we have the Noble gases. And then what else? H2O2 F2 Cl2. These are the gases and how they are naturally occurring. How about the liquid? Liquids, I gave you three examples only, which are what?
Mercury.
Mercury, Hg liquid, yes.
Osmium.
No.
Br.
Cesium, which is the last element of the periodic table and the alkali metal. Cesium liquid, what else?
Chrome.
Br. What?
Liquid.
Two liquid. You must put two for bromine. Clear? And for the solid, they are all one. The rest are solid. They are all one except one, which is what? Iodine is solid. I2. Clear? Any question? Of course, yesterday somebody asked, but that's not important for us here. We're going to consider that sulfur as S, not even though it's actually occurring as S8. But for the specific of this chapter, we're going to use S regularly, and also phosphorus. P exists as P4, but again, for this course, for this chapter, we're going to use S as 1 and P as 1 also. All right, clear? Good. Let's solve this problem. Yes. One by one. Okay, there is also another rule that delta H of any reaction is equal to what? Summation of heat of formation of product minus summation of heat of formation of reactants. Is this clear? Good. Let's solve this problem. See, the heat of formation is available in your book in Appendix 2. If you go, if you have your book with you, you will find the heat of formation for so many compounds are given to you in Appendix 2. If you go to Appendix 2 in your book, at the end of the book, you will find that the heat of formation is available. The heat of formation of AgCl, if you look at the table, is minus 127.0. And for Cl minus, it is minus 167.2. And for Ag plus, it is 105.9. So what's delta H for this reaction? What's the delta H for this reaction? Everything is one. You don't have to multiply by anything. So we're going to say it's one times. Minus 127.0 for the product. And then minus. And then open big bracket. And what should you do say?
105.9
minus 1 times, or you can say plus 1 plus times minus 167.2. And I deliberately put 1 here. Everything is 1 because actually in the equation everything is 1. If it's 2, you have to put 2 for each one. Okay, very quickly, what's the answer for this question? Yes.
Product minus.
Yes. Product minus reactant. Product minus reactant.
Minus 65.7.
Okay, minus 65.7. Who got the same answer? I hope you did.
I got the chance.
Great. All right. Next. Now, this is a question. This is both heat of formation and Hess law. What is this saying? Given the following information, calculate the standard heat of formation of acetylene. So, what do we want? We want to make acetylene, C2H2. And we want to calculate what's delta H formation standard of C2H2. So in order to calculate the heat formation, what's the equation that you should write. See
number 3.
Graphite. What do you mean by number 3?
I will multiply the equation by 2.
No, just a second. First, let's write the equation for the heat formation of C2H2. What's the equation for the heat formation of C2H2?
2C.
2C graphite, exactly.
Plus H2.
Plus H2
gas.
Yes.
Exactly. And how much here? Only one. Exactly. All right. And to make this as gas. Now, use the three equations here to find the heat formation of C2H2. Use his slope. What are you going to do with equation 1, 2, and 3?
1 keep it as it is.
One keep. Are you sure?
No, one
yes.
Reverse. Multiply by 2.
No.
Keep. One reverse.
No.
Keep it as it is. 2. You must multiply by 2, first one. Okay, second one.
Second.
What?
Keep it
as it is.
Multiply by 2.
No, just simply keep. Exactly. Third one.
Flip it. Reverse. And divide by 2.
Divide by 2 or multiply by half. Exactly. All right. Okay, do it. Do you have an answer?
Two hundred twenty-six point six.
Two six. Let's see. Did you get it, all of you? 226.6 exactly. So 226.6 is the correct answer. Okay, 226.6. Excellent. Okay. All right. We did this just a while ago. Right. Good. Sodium peroxide react with liquid water. Okay, right equation. Sodium peroxide react with liquid water, yielding aqueous sodium hydroxide and oxygen gas. All right, so what's the equation that you should write?
2Na plus O2.
A product. O2. React with what?
H2O.
to make
NaOH
in sodium hydroxide plus
O2
gas. All right. What's delta H for this reaction? Given the following, first, is this balanced? What's the next thing you should do?
Multiply
multiply by 2 for the NA2.
What else?
The water.
The water.
What should I do with the water?
Multiply it by 4.
We have a 3-3, yes.
Or no, no.
We have 3-3 in water.
No, yeah. First, the sodium is 2-2. Okay, hydrogen, we have 2 here and 2 here, no problem. The only thing left is oxygen. So we have 1-2 and here 3. And we have already 2 here. So this should be half. As a result, multiply now everything by 2.
Doctor, we can't hear you.
We have 4 sodium, 4 okay, 4 sodium, 4 sodium, 4 hydrogen, and then oxygen we have 4 and 2, 6, and we have here 4 here and 2 here, 6, so it's balanced. Okay, calculate delta H from this information, quickly.
Dr. Dolov, delta H is delta H for product minus reactant or the opposite?
Cool. Delta H of this reaction equal to, because we have heat of formation, this is all heat of formation. So you should say delta H equal to summation of heat of product. First, let's go with product. What's the heat of formation of oxygen, O2? O2.
Zero.
No problem. But we have only in the product 4 times what?
Minus 469.6.
Okay. And then big minus, and then big bracket, and then what's next? 2 times. What? Minus
510.9,
and then
plus
again 2 times
minus
285.8, and then close the bracket. Okay, give me an answer. Quickly.
The answer will be minus 285.
Yes.
285?
Yes.
Who got the same answer?
Yes, I got the same answer.
285 kilojoule per mole. Now, the question is saying if you are producing 327.2 gram of oxygen. So we have 327.2 gram of high oxygen, O2. Then how much total heat? I should change this first to what?
2 mole.
1 mole or two, and then down here, what should I write?
32.
32 gram O2. And then how much heat? Each 1 mole or two, because of the equation, there is one here. 1 mole or two, give us how much heat?
-0.
No, -2. And the reaction now, -285 kilojoule. And then you get the answer. What's the answer you have?
-2.2914.
2914. This is 2914. All right.
Minus sign with minus sign.
Good. I did not write the minus sign. Is my answer correct?
Yes.
Correct. Why?
Because the heat is gain for the what system.
It's written there.
What it is?
Heat is released. Released means it is minus, but I don't have to write it. I want the total heat. I can tell you that if you have on the multiple choice, if I say in the multiple choice how much heat is released, and if you want to choose answer, it's okay to choose. If there is answer, if there is minus, choose the one with minus. But if it already says how much heat is released, even if it's positive, it will be correct. Because it already says in the question how much heat released. Released means exothermic, means if by sign it should be positive, but I don't have to write the minus because I already said how much heat will be released. Is this clear?
دكتور ما فهمت أنا ليش الـ O2 أعطانا 285 كيلو جول آخر خطوة.
This thing here 285 is the heat of this reaction. This is 285. It's not the oxygen. It's 285 kilo joule per mole. Kilo joule per mole.
Oh, has the reaction.
Yes, because we know that delta H of reaction equal to summation of heat of formation of product minus summation heat of formation of reactant. And we did heat formation for each one of them. And that's why we got 285. I hope this is clear. Good. Yes, it is the answer. So if you see the answer 2914, it's good again because I say here energy released. When I say released means exothermic.
دكتور إذا شفت في الخيارات واحد بوزيتيف وواحد ماينس تختار.
هذا خطأ. لو كان الخيارين موجودين الجوابين صحيح، فالمفروض ما يكونوا موجودين. Because the minus is by agreement, by convention. ف if I say release, this is the energy. I don't have to say minus. That's all. Very quickly, calculate the delta H for ionization of hydrogen bromide. Hydrogen bromide. Again, one more thing. Of the ions, all the ions I'll give you this information now. We did not talk about the ions. The heat of formation of H plus is also equal to zero. I'm not going to give you this information, but you should keep it in your mind. Only H plus of the ion aqueous H plus, the heat of formation is zero. So very quickly, what's that H for this reaction? Come on.
Minus 83.8.
83
or it's actually 84.
84.7 I got. 84.7 minus 84.7. Yes, 84.7, that's what I got.
Yes, sorry.
Is this clear? What did you do? Don't forget, this is equal to zero, and this is equal to minus 120.9, and this one minus 36.2, I hope. Good. Very quickly again, calculate delta H for this reaction. What's delta H?
Doctor, F is zero, L is zero, yes.
You should tell me, what's the heat formation of aluminum?
Solid. Zero.
Zero. What's the heat formation of iron solid?
Zero.
Zero, exactly. So what's the heat formation of the reaction? Quickly, I need an answer.
Minus 3,360.5.
Who got the same answer?
Yes.
You get it? I hope so. And it is the correct answer. All right. Calculate the overall change in internal energy in joule for a system that absorb. So Q in this case, absorb means what?
Positive.
Positive 188. And does work. What's the word?
141.
Is it positive or negative?
Negative.
Everybody,
positive.
No, negative.
The why?
System doing work on surrounding. So W negative. Is this clear? All right. So what's you?
Q plus W.
Which is equal to what?
Forty-seven
plus or minus?
Plus.
Plus.
Okay, good. All right, we did this before. Let's go to questions. What? Okay. Let's go to chapter 10. I have I want to review chapter 10 very quickly. While we do this, let's do the attendance as usual. Okay. Do you have the site?
لا دكتور ممكن ترسله بس.
It's available Microsoft. I don't want anybody to say I don't see it. It is available here now. It is sent to you now. Now and then share.
دكتور وين؟
Accept responses. Go ahead quickly.
دكتور مو مو.
أسوي رفريش تو فاتح.
One more time. سكر وافتح بسرعة وحيفتح راسه.
خلاص سوينا ولا نسوي مرة ثانية الحين؟
لا لا خلاص سوينا مرة واحدة. Then did I close it?
لا دكتور بس خلنا. معلش دكتور بس لعبت بشوي.
يا دكتور.
كيف؟
دكتور بس دقيقة بس دقيقة دكتور بس بيشتغل الحين.
انتظر انتظر انا بفطر الشباب على اساس. Alright. That's I have two problems, quick problems. Yes, quickly, let's solve this problem. Okay. What is the URMS fluorine gas at 30 degrees C? URMS of chlorine gas. It's from chapter 10. So what we want here, we want to calculate URMS of chlorine gas. What's the equation that I should use?
Square root of
3RT over
2.
What's this?
Molar mass.
Molecular mass.
In what? What unit?
Gram.
No.
In kilo.
Go ahead and calculate your RMS for chlorine gas. Don't forget, chlorine gas is what? Cl2 gas. All right. Okay, I'm going to take this out now. All right, one more time.
What's R, doctor?
R, what's R you should use?
Equal to 8.4 or what?
8.31. You should go to your periodic table. Use the R, which is 8.31.
263.8.
No, wrong answer. Don't forget that
Cl2
gas.
Oh, Cl2. Okay.
Not Cl. So don't forget that U equal to URMS equal to square root of 3RT over the molar mass, and you should have the molar mass of chlorine for 1 Cl is 35.45. Don't forget you're going to use Cl2, not Cl, and make it kilogram. So I need an answer.
2.3
No, the speed is much higher than this.
10.31
You should put 3. Oh, temperature. Don't forget the temperature. 326. You should add. Yes, that's the answer. You should add 30 plus 273.15 to make it Kelvin. All right, and multiply it by 8.3. times 3, and then the molar mass, which is 70.9? Yeah. 70.9 times 10 to the power minus 3 to make it kilogram. Okay, so what's the answer?
326.5.
Exactly. I hope you got it. Okay, determine how much faster helium atom moves on average than carbon dioxide. Helium is HE, and carbon dioxide is CO2. Which CO2. One is faster? Which one is faster, helium or CO2?
Helium.
Of
course, helium is faster. If I want to calculate the speed of helium compared to the speed of CO2, what's this equal to?
Molecular mass of CO2 over molecular mass of helium.
Molar mass of CO2 divided by the molar mass of helium. What's the molar mass of CO2 and what's the mass of of helium? For CO2 is 44.01 and for helium around 4.003 if you want to go to get it from the periodic table. So what's the answer? Should I put in this in kilogram or keep it as is?
As it is.
It is as it is. Regardless what's the unit, because the unit will cancel with each other. Gram will go with gram, or if it's kilogram, it will be times 10 to the power minus 3, and times 10 to the power 3 minus 3, also they will cancel each other. So it's the same thing. You can keep it as kilogram or gram or anything else. Is this clear? I hope so. And with this, we'll finish the lecture and see you, inshallah, next Monday.
Thank you.
Doctor?
Now.
Can we ask you a favor, please?
Yes.